Hello and welcome back everyone, I'm Lincoln, and today we're going to jump into Nomad Sculpt again, and I want to show you the differences between the trim tool and the project tool. Now, they do similar things if you know how to use them properly, but they treat your topology in two completely different ways. One respects it a little bit more than the other, and you might be surprised by which one it is. Alright, let's get into it. Okay, so first I'm going to show you the wire, because that's one of the more important things to understand is how the wire affects this. So if we leave this just in the topology it is, which if you know how the topology works, go on to the topology tab, and this is actually in multi-resolution. As you can see, we can go down, should be able to go down, and we could subdivide if you want, and you can see it goes higher and higher. Let's put that in there. Okay. So, we don't want to delete the lower. Let's go back down, or we can just tap back. We'll just tap back. Okay, so you know that if you voxel remesh, this is going to go into regular cubic. So if we do that, you see it goes back into regular cubes. All right, so to demonstrate how these two tools work differently, we'll leave it in the regular topology it comes in. So if we use the trim tool and we use the lasso, which you've probably used a bunch, if you cut this, and that's in symmetry, we can turn symmetry off. Cut this and we turn it, you can see that it goes into dynamic topology, which if you go up here, you'll see the dyno topo tab with the diamond. And this is basically what this would be, even though it's not telling you that. Now there is something you do to fix this, so it's a little bit better at least. So first off, you see how it's trimmed, and it's this area right here is not cut straight through, and it's not respecting your topology as well. So you can fix this to a point. So if you come back into the trim tool, tap up here on the settings and go from legacy, you can go to Boolean, let's try that one more time, go into Boolean, that will fix it as well. But you can also increase this detail tab. And if you go all the way up, you know, you can go up quite a bit. I'm not sure, yeah, 500 is the max, but say we go up to 370-ish and we do the same thing, it's gonna trim it much cleaner. But if you turn to the side, you can see that it's gone to dynamic topology, and you'll see that automatically your topology on the sphere has gone to cubic topology, just like you voxel remeshed it. Now, if you don't want to do that, then you can go into trim, hit on the settings tab, and go into Boolean, and it will still do the same thing. It's still going to change your topology, but it will keep it a little bit cleaner. But you can see that if you're in multi-resolution, you're gonna lose it automatically because you did a Boolean operation. So instead, we can look at the project tool. Now the project tool acts a little bit different than the regular trim tool, but the one interesting thing about it is curve, path, line, rectangle, ellipse, depending on how you use them, will leave your topology in multi-resolution. So say we're in curve. Now, you'll notice right here that we have that arrow right here. Now that arrow, you flip back and forth, and I had it in flip already. So if we flip it back to normal, you see the arrow is pointing in towards the object. So that means you're gonna cut that out. Now, if we do this the opposite way and you flip it, it cuts this way. It's kind of a nice shortcut, but you'll notice sometimes at the top there, we got a weird line, and it will do some weird things with the topology sometimes. Which, if you just voxel remesh, it'll totally get rid of that for you. But if you don't get too extreme with it and stay relatively close to your object, that's not going to happen. It's only going to happen if you have this line way out, because it's trying to respect topology all along that line. So when it does that, sometimes it'll do it, sometimes it won't. Since we've already trimmed one, you go up high like this, sometimes it will. And I think also if you go directly from trim back into project, it seems like there's a little bit of a bug there sometimes, because most of the time this will work clean, but it seems like if you go between trim and project, it will do that sometimes. So project tool. Now that's how the regular curve works. It's kind of like lasso without being a full lasso. It'll only just do a line, because it's, think of it as projecting an object onto a screen, like a movie screen. So same thing with a path. Path is also a little bit different because you don't have the full diameter like you normally do with a polygon. And same thing, you'll notice there's the arrow in the center right there, right in between. And if you hit the green dot, just like a polygon cut, cleans it. But the thing you'll notice is your multi-resolution stays intact. And for the most part, your cut is going to be right where you asked for it to be. Now, every once in a while, I'll have an issue with that too. Still kind of buggy sometimes with project. But if you go out, come back in, sometimes it'll cut right on the line. Sometimes it'll be a little off. It's still a little buggy, but as far as respecting topology, it's much better than a trim tool. Okay, so project, there's a couple other things that people don't understand about the project tool. The line is still what it's gonna be. Your line is still gonna be a line, but same thing, it's still gonna respect topology, even if it gets a little funky. And that still looks pretty good. So let's go back to home again. Now, the last two, these act a little bit differently. Now, if you go, let's go into the trim tool first and show you how these. So you know how polygon works, I'm sure. It's same thing, drag one out and cut it when you hit the dot, if I can hit it. And does pretty decent, okay. If you go to the project tool and do the same thing, trim tool with rectangle. All right, getting ahead of myself. Now you see here, there's no dot in the center of this. Now you'll notice when we go into project, there's a pink dot in the center. That makes a big difference project. But in this case, we're cutting pretty clean. Now this is because in trim, we went over to Boolean. If you're in legacy, you'll notice that a lot of times it's not quite as clean. It'll still be pretty decent, but you'll still have that little bit of weirdness going on in the lines there. And you can still clean that up some, you know, if you just want to use trim tool instead of the project tool, you can go up the hole smoothing, knock that all the way down. And when you do a trim with a rectangle, it's pretty much going to hit it right on the nose and be nice and square. So that still cuts it very well. If you're not worried about the topology and being dynamic, go for it. That's an easy way to use it. Instead, if you want to do the project tool, it will exactly do the same thing. And you have the square where it'll always do a square instead of a rectangle. It'll do centered wherever you pull from your center. Or I'll turn those off. Now, this is the point I was talking about. In your rectangle and the circle, if you pull this and you keep that little circle off of your object, it will cut. You'll notice though that the topology may not be as clean because it is respecting it. And since it's not as high a poly count, it's not gonna be as good. So the way to fix that is come into your multi-resolution, subdivide it couple times, and that should do it. Now do the project, do this rectangle again, and it'll cut it much cleaner again and respect topology. Still not going to be perfect, but it's close. Now, the other thing that's interesting with this, and this may be a little hard to explain, but I'm going to see if I can make this happen. Okay, now if you make that salmon colored pink dot on the object, you make it touch the object wherever you're looking at, and that at the height of the object. So think of you rotating this 90 degrees, and you can see the object formed like this. wherever that dot is on the surface is where the center of this project is going to go. And you'll see what I mean now. So if we bring this in, if we do this again, it's going to cut, right? So if we don't want to do that, we're going to come in and we want to project a shape onto this. And you see the dot is on top now, right there. So if we do this, it's right in the center. We turn and it adds to your object instead of subtracts it. Okay. Now, if we do it a little bit differently and we put it up high where this dot is right at the edge, it's going to cut and build at the same time. And I'll show you what I mean. So when you rotate, now you're going to have it, because that dot was basically in this area right in the center, that's where the plane is going to build. So I don't know if you understand how that works. Hopefully that makes sense to you. Same thing with the circle now. It does the exact same thing with the ellipse and circle. You do here, it cuts. You get up over here, it's going to build. Now, it is a very quick way to build an object and a surface up, because you can do these at will all over the object. And if you do it with symmetry, it acts just the same. It should act the same, but we don't have symmetry engaged on all axes, so let's do that. So of course you'd want to fix which ones you're on symmetry with, but you can see how it respects what's been built before. So it's kind of an interesting feature. So we'll go back, and then there's one more thing I want to show you with the project tool. And that is how to add parts onto this. And that's another way to quickly build something up. So let's go back and just kind of do the regular, so the resolution is not so high. And you could also just go back up here if that had been, and subdivide. You can, I don't know if you guys have messed with this much, but you can bring this down to a lower subdivision. Okay. So with the project, there's another kind of a crazy thing that happens with this tool. And if you've seen people use this before, a lot of people, this is one of the last things that I think a lot of people don't understand how to use this tool properly. So if we go to curve and I go right here. Now, you see with the direction the arrow is pointed right there, it's pointed in towards the object, so nothing's gonna happen. So you think, oh, that's dumb. But if you go this and you flip it, now what's going to happen is this is going to project, and it's kind of going to project in the direction of that arrow. So if the arrow is in a different spot like this, then it'll project up and it does weird things. So that didn't actually do what we want to do. And the reason is that it has to have a piece of this object needs to be masked. So your select mask is something else you're going to use with this particular tool. We'll use rectangle, it doesn't matter. You just need, whoops, I don't need symmetry. You just need a part of this in the back masked. So now when you use project and use the curve and we go out, you can see that it's going out. Once again, if it's going this way, we'll do nothing. But if we turn this the other direction with a flip button, now it goes out respecting the surface normals. And if you go over, you can see it does, that's exactly what it does. So it's kind of an interesting thing. It only works if you have it masked, and it will only work in one direction. So I'll demonstrate that as well. If you're on select mask and we do a small mask in the center and we try to project one side to do symmetry on the other side, it's going to do weird things, because it's going to pull this area over here that's over in this area is going to go over as well. So if you're on project, we're on curve, and we come out like this, it's gonna do weird things because it's in symmetry. So I haven't figured out how to use symmetry with this. It's only just if you wanna add parts to this. So if we have this masked again. Now, another thing too to understand is if you only have part of this masked and you try to project past the boundaries of this mask, you'll see what happens. It does weird things. If we're up here, it's going to pull and it'll just destroy the rest of it. So it does this weird thing like that where it kind of sucks it up to the projection wall. Think of that line as like a projection screen. It's going to project anything on the object to that screen. So kind of an interesting feature. Like you said, if you have this masked all the way and then you do your project line, say it's just a little one, it'll just do that. If you just want to do this, it'll go straight. You know, and it's kind of cool. It's like a super fast extrude. You can really blow a shape out very quickly. So I hope this helps explain the difference between these tools. They both have their uses. And like I said, with the trim tool, you know, for the longest time, the trim didn't work that great. I mean, it was okay. But as far as the lasso went, if you wanted to do nice hard cuts like that, it wasn't going to happen unless we had this to where we could change the detail. And if you go all the way up to 500, now it's going to be a much cleaner cut. You know, it's not going to respect the geometry as much, but it was still, you know, as far as being dynamic or not dynamic, but at least it will keep your line straight. Because if you see this all the way at the low detail, at a regular 100 detail, and we do this, the one thing that I didn't like, well, one of two things, is you look at the, you know, you've got these areas right here that are a little off, but then also your lines right here, like this spot right here, has a hump in it instead of just being a straight cut. So it's nice that now we, at least with all these new updates we've had, that we can go in and we can change your detail. So it really helps when you want to do just a quick chop, and it makes it nice and clean. And then if you want to fix this, all you have to do is come up to the voxel, you know, go up quite a bit. And when you do that, you're going to have a nice, clean object to work with. You know, there's still a little bit of something going on right here, but that's pretty easy to fix with a smooth brush. So anyway, I hope this helps. And this is something that will really help you clean up your cuts, and maybe we'll use the trim a little bit more often. All right, I'll see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching, and please like and subscribe if this helps you out. All right, we'll see you.